To my YouTube channel. So let's continue Aranyakanda.
News to Ravana. Akampat was the only demon who survived the battle. He reached Ravana's court to tell him the news about it and the death of Kara, Dushana, Trishira and the soldiers. It seemed as if every soldiers were battling Rama, said Akampan. This was a part of Rama's power of illusion, but it did not lessen the terrible anger of Ravana. Who killed them? He thundered. Yama or Agni or Vishnu? I can defeat even Yama. It was as if many-headed snakes erupted from each arrow shot by Rama, said Akampan. Still in a state of shock, only after he was assured of safety by Ravana, did Akampan tell him about the details of the battle? The only way to defeat Rama appears to be to separate his beautiful and beloved wife, Sita, from him. My lord, if she can be abducted, perhaps he can be defeated, suggested Akampan. Ravana's history. Once Ravana had tried to move Mount Kailash, the abode of Shiva and his wife Parvati. Annoyed with him, Shiva pressed the mountain down and Ravana's hands were caught under it. He screamed with pain and was advised to please Lord Shiva. So when he recited and sang songs in praise of Shiva, he was mercifully released. That is when he was named Ravana, which means cream, in place of his old name, Dashagriva, or the ten-headed one. He was the son of a saint and a demoness. Kaikasi Kubera was his stepbrother. His siblings were Kumbhakarna, Shurpanaka, and Vibhishana. The brothers wished to be rich and powerful like Kubera, so they performed austerities to please Brahma. Ravana asked to be indestructible from Devas, any celestial being or Asuras. Kumbhakarna wished to sleep for long and Vibhishana asked that he might be steady in right conduct. All their wishes were granted.
Ravana becomes king of Lanka. Ravana began to attack kings and princes and devas and take away their kingdoms and positions. Kubera advised him to stop. Ravana's advisors counseled him to attack Kubera and take Lanka from him. Ravana wondered in his mind whether he should attack his elder brother. During this time, he met an old man and his daughter in a forest. This was Maya, the architect, and his daughter Mandodari, who was known for her wisdom and beauty. Perhaps the best thing Ravana did was to marry Mandodari. Finally, he decided to attack his brother and destroy Alkapuri, his capital. He also took away the Pushpaka Vimana flying chariot that belonged to Kubera. Shiva sent his messenger, Nandi, who was sharp and dark, to find out what was going on. Ravana laughed at him and called him a monkey. Annoyed, Nandi cursed that his destruction would come through a monkey.
Ravana consults Maricha. The description of Sita's beauty made Ravana abduct her and make her his own possession. Like all the other valuable things he had collected in his golden kingdom of Lanka, it would be an added pleasure to make Rama suffer for killing his brothers and demon army. Ravana decided to consult Maricha, who he knew had faced Rama in the combat. Maricha had become an ascetic after the battle. He sought Maricha's help to abduct Sita in revenge for the death of Kara, Dushana and the demon army. Maricha advised Ravana, "Go home to your wife and family, my lord. Even the thought of abducting Sita is misconduct and insulting. I assure you that if you do this, the entire race of demons and our family shall be destroyed." Ravana realized the wisdom of Maricha's advice and returned to his palace. Shurpanaka incites Ravana. Ravana, although a very learned person and a devotee of Lord Shiva, had committed many crimes against devas and sages and women. His destruction was certain. As he sat in his court, Shurpanaka entered wailing and screaming with her mutilated nose and ears. "What happened to you?" asked Ravana, shocked to see his sister in this condition. The king of Rakshasas mocked Shurpanaka. Knowing Ravana's weakness for beautiful women and Rama, a mere human being living in a forest, killed your whole army. And when I tried to snatch Sita, more beautiful than the moon, to bring her to you, look that Lakshmana did to me. Now you have to avenge my humiliation by kidnapping Sita," challenged Shurpanaka. Ravana sat lost in thought, balancing Maricha's wise advice against the words of Shurpanaka and his own desire for revenge and for Sita. Ravana manipulates Maricha. Ravana's wisdom was destroyed by his desires. He went to Maricha again, and this time he used another tactic to involve him in his evil plan. "Maricha, our sister Shurpanaka has been insulted. Her nose and ears have been cut off by the princess of Ayodhya. We cannot let the disgrace go without punishment. Our warriors have been killed and the devas and the sages are moving about freely in the forest. I need your help to punish Rama," said Ravana. "I want you to go to Panjavadi in the guise of a golden deer and play there to attract Sita's attention. She will send Rama after you, tempted by your golden skin." "And what if Rama shoots me?" asked Maricha. "If Rama shoots you, cry out Lakshmana's name in Rama's voice. Sita will send Lakshmana and that will give me a chance to kidnap her," explained Ravana. Maricha's decision. "What happens if I refuse to do this?" asked Maricha. "I will cut off your head right now," threatened Ravana. Maricha thought about it for a while. "I have to die. In any case, Ravana will cut off my head if I refuse to carry out his orders. If I do what he asks me, I'll be doing something that is very wrong. Ravana will certainly be destroyed along with the entire race of demons. But I will be able to see Lord Rama following me as I run in the forest in the form of a deer. It will be his hand that will kill me, not Ravana's. So perhaps I shall attain salvation by dying at Rama's feet after seeing him as the last living vision." It was a difficult choice, but finally Maricha agreed to do Ravana's bidding. The golden deer. Maricha went with Ravana in the Pushpaka Vimana to the place where Panjavati was situated, Maricha transformed himself into a beautiful golden stag. The magical deer began to frolic near the hut of Rama and Sita, sometimes grazing and sometimes running towards the water. Sometimes grazing and sometimes running towards the water. Sita was plucking flowers for worship and made garlands. Suddenly, the movement of the stag caught her eye and she stopped to watch the beautiful creature. She was fascinated by its glossy golden coat. She longed to have the deer skin. Sita drew Rama's and Lakshmana's attention to the golden stag and asked them to fetch it for her. Lakshmana felt the deer might be a demon in disguise, but Rama loved for Sita and led him to try in order to fulfill her wish. "Take care of Sita while I fetch the deer, Lakshmana," said Rama as he took his bow and arrow to follow the golden creature. Time for winding up the video. See you in the next part. Bye.